जय राधा माधवा कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी। जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावन चारी, यमुना तीरावन चारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय गोपी जन वल्लभ गिरिवर धारी, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यशोदा नंदन ब्रज जन रंजन, यमुना तीरावन चारी। जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी, जय राधा माधव कुंज बिहारी।
जय ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोदरक श्री श्रीमदिस डिवाइन ग्रेस लभय चरणारविंद भक्ति वेदांत गोस्वामी महाराज श्रील प्रभुपाद की, इस्कॉन विविध संस्थापक आचार्य श्रील प्रभुपाद की जय। ओम विष्णुपाद परमहंस परिव्राजकाचार्य अष्टोदरक श्री श्रीमदिस डिवाइन ग्रेस श्रील भक्त सिद्धांत सरस्वती ठाकुर प्रभुपाद की, अनंत कोटि वैष्णव वृंद की, नामाचार्य शिल हरिदास ठाकुर की, प्रेम से कहो श्री कृष्ण चैतन्य प्रभु नितानंद श्री अद्वैत गदाधर शिवासदि गौर भक्त वृंद की, श्री श्री राधा कृष्ण गोप गोपीनाथ श्याम कुंड राधा कुंड श्री गिरि गोवर्धन की, ब्रज भूमि श्री वृंदावन धाम की, मथुरापुरी धाम की, गोकुल महावन धाम की, गंगा माई जमुना माई की, भक्ति देवी तुलसी महारानी की, कलयुग पावन हरिनाम संकीर्तन की, हरे कृष्ण महामंत्र की, नवद्वीप जगन्नाथपुरी धाम की, ताई गौर प्रेमनंदे, ऑल ग्लोरियस टू असेंबल डिवोटीज, ऑल ग्लोरियस टू असेंबल डिवोटीज, ऑल ग्लोरियस टू असेंबल डिवोटीज, ऑल ग्लोरीज ऑल ग्लोरीज ऑल ग्लोरियस टू श्री गुरु एंड श्री गौरांग। ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय, ओम नमो भगवते वासुदेवाय नारायणं नमस्कृत्य नरं चैव नरोत्तमं देवीं सरस्वतीं व्यासं ततो जयमुदीरयेत् नष्टप्रायेषु अभद्रेषु नित्यं भागवत सेवया भगवती उत्तम श्लोके भक्तिर्भवति नैष्ठिकी कृष्णाय वासुदेवाय देवकी नंदनाय च नंदगोपकुमाराय गोविंदाय नमो नमः। ओम अज्ञानतिमिरंधस्य ज्ञानांजनशलाकया चक्षुरोन्मीलितं येन तस्मै श्रीगुरवे नमः। नम ओं विष्णुपदाय कृष्णप्रेष्ठाय भूतले श्रीमते भक्ति वेदांत स्वामिनिति नामिने। नमस्ते सरस्वती देवे गौरवाणी प्रचारिणे निर्विशेष शून्यवादी पाश्चात्य देश तारिणे वांछा कल्पतरुभ्यश्च कृपा सिंधुभ्य एव च पतितानां पावनेभ्यो वैष्णवेभ्यो नमो नमः। नमो महावदन्याय कृष्ण प्रेम प्रदायते कृष्णाय कृष्ण चैतन्या नामने गौरत्विषे नमः। पञ्चतत्त्वात्मकं कृष्ण भक्तरूपस्वरूपकं भक्तावतारं भक्ताख्यं नमामि भक्तशक्तिकम्। हे कृष्णा करुणा सिंधु दीनबंधु जगत्पते गोपेश गोपिका कांता श्री राधा कांत नमोस्तुते तप्त कांचन गौरांगी श्री राधे वृंदावनेश्वरी वृषभानुसुते देवी प्रणमामि हरिप्रिये श्री कृष्ण चैतन्या प्रभु नित्यानंदा श्री अद्वैत गदाधार श्रीवासदि गौर भक्त वृंदा। हरे कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्णा हरे हरे
हरे रामो हरे रामो 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 रामो 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 हरे 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 कृष्णा कृष्ण कृष्ण हरे 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 रामो 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 हरे हरे
रीडिंग फ्रॉम श्रीमद् भागवतम कैंटो 10 चैप्टर 1 चैप्टर एंटाइटल्ड द एडवेंट ऑफ लॉर्ड कृष्णा इंट्रोडक्शन टेक्स्ट नंबर 4
निवृत्ता तर्षैः उपगीयमानात् भवौषधात् श्रोत्र मनः अभिरामात् कः उत्तम श्लोक गुणानुवादात् पुमान् विरज्येत विना पशुघ्नात् निवृत्ततर्षैरुपगीयमानात् भवौषधात् श्रोत्रमनोभिरामात् क उत्तम श्लोक गुणानुवादात् पुमान् विरज्येत विना पशुघ्नात् निवृत्ततर्षैरुपगीयमानात् भवौषधात् श्रोत्रमनोभिरामात् क उत्तम श्लोक गुणानुवादात् पुमान् विरज्येत विना पशुघ्नात् निवृत्ततर्षैरुपगीयमानात् भवौषधात् श्रोत्रमनोभिरामात् क उत्तम श्लोक गुणानुवादात् पुमान् विरज्येत विना पशुघ्नात् कुमान विरजेत बिना पशुघ्ना।
माता जी भवौ सदा श्रोत्र मनोभिराम। निवृत्त रिलीज्ड फ्रॉम तरशैर लस्ट और मटेरियल एक्टिविटीज उपगीयमानात विच इज डिस्क्राइब्ड और संग भवौषधात विच इज द राइट मेडिसिन फॉर द मटेरियल डिजीज श्रोत्र द प्रोसेस ऑफ ऑरल रिसेप्शन मनः द सब्जेक्ट मैटर ऑफ थॉट फॉर द माइंड अभिरामात फ्रॉम द प्लीजिंग वाइब्रेशन फ्रॉम सच ग्लोरिफिकेशन। कह हु उत्तम श्लोक ऑफ द सुप्रीम पर्सनैलिटी ऑफ गॉडहेड गुणानुवादात फ्रॉम डिस्क्राइबिंग सच एक्टिविटीज पुमान अ पर्सन विरज्येत कैन कीप हिमसेल्फ अलूफ विना एक्सेप्ट पशुघ्नात आइदर अ बुचर और वन हु इज किलिंग His own personal existence. Translation and purport by His Divine Grace, A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada. Translation. Glorification of the Supreme Personality of Godhead is performed in the parampara system. That is, it is conveyed from the spiritual master to the disciple. Such glorification is relished by those no longer interested in the false temporary glorification of this cosmic manifestation. Descriptions of the Lord are the right medicine for the conditioned soul undergoing repeated birth and death. Therefore, who will cease hearing such glorification of the Lord except a butcher or one who is killing his own self? Purport. In India, it is the practice amongst the general populace to hear about Krishna either from Bhagavad Gita or from Srimad Bhagavatam in order to gain release from the disease of repeated birth and death. Although India is now fallen, when there is a message that someone will speak about Bhagavad Gita or Srimad Bhagavatam, thousands of people still gather to hear. This verse indicates, however, that such recitation of Bhagavad Gita and Srimad Bhagavatam must be done by persons completely freed from material desires, nivritta tarishair. Everyone within this material world, beginning from Brahma down to the insignificant ant, is full of material desires for sense enjoyment, and everyone is busy in sense gratification. But when thus engaged, one cannot fully understand the value of Krishna Katha, either in the form of Bhagavad Gita or in Srimad Bhagavatam. Jai Srila Prabhupada ki. So this is a very beautiful verse from the 10th canto, and we welcome all the devotees on the occasion of Sri Krishna Janmashtami Mahamohotsav 2012. So welcome to a full day of chanting, dancing, abhishek and fasting. But here, Parikshit Maharaj has been fasting for 4.5 days, and not just fasting, but he has not been sleeping also. And in spite of that, he is hearing attentively the Srimad Bhagavatam. So this is a very beautiful verse. In this verse, it is described why Krishna appeared in this world. One of the great Christian philosophers, he wrote that generally the memory of a person or society doesn't last for more than 2000 years. And then many times after that, the reality of the existence of that person comes under question. So he was making a theory that a time will come when people will start actually questioning whether Jesus Christ really came or not. And so we find that it is not uncommon to find people asking this question: did Krishna really come? Is Krishna for real? You are chanting Hare Krishna, Hare Ram. Are you referring to a real God? Or you are just chanting his names because you have no time, you know, no other thing to do in life? Why do you are doing this? So therefore, in this particular verse, three categories of people are described. The first category is one who is Nivritta Tarshair. Nivritta Tarshair means one who is free from any material desires. So Krishna appears in this world to reinstate the reality of his pastimes, to demonstrate how his pastimes are true and real and perfect. How my pastimes are a Sat, Chit and Ananda. How my pastimes can transform the heart even of the most ignorant. And in order to demonstrate this, paritranaya sadhunam vinashaya cha dushkritam dharma sansthapanarthaya sambhavami yuge yuge. So one should not think that this verse only refers to the fact that Kamsa had to be taken care of. So he came. He did a good job and went. Krishna was really effective. Very, very inspiring to see how he killed Kamsa. But I am already Arjuna. So, it doesn't make much difference to me. But our heart is filled with Kamsa-like propensities and a host of other demoniac propensities. And therefore, Krishna appears to establish Bhagavad Dharma within our heart. Dharma sansthapanarthaya is Bhagavad Dharma. And how we can serve Krishna, ahaituki apratihata yajatma suprasidati. Please the Lord with our undivided devotional service. So therefore, three categories are described here. Nivritta Tarshair. Generally in this world it is seen that which is pleasing to the devotees is not pleasing to the non-devotees. And that which is pleasing to the non-devotees is not pleasing to the devotees. And all of us have experience of this fact. Like for example, we are celebrating Janmashtami here. So this is very pleasing to the devotees. But someone who doesn't believe in Krishna and who doesn't like Krishna or is full of skeptical ideas, he will not accept this. One time I was giving a lecture in IIT, one boy came to me after the class and asked me that why are you making this big story about Krishna appearing as the 8th son? After all, the Akashvani said that the 8th son is going to kill Kamsa. Why didn't Kamsa just keep Vasudeva and Devaki in different prison cells? So if he had kept them separate, 8th son would have never come. Because even first son would not be born. because if they are kept separate, how any son will come? I said, he should have asked you in IIT. So people have this kind of a mentality to question and think that all of these pastimes are under scrutiny, are under question. So, Nivritta Tarshair Upagiyamana Krishna Katha, it is described by Parikshit Maharaj, who is going to die in 7 days and seven nights. He is describing that how Krishna Katha is all attractive to the muktas, to the ones who are liberated. Bhavaushadat, to those who are in the process of being transformed. What is the meaning of Bhavaushadat? Bhavaushadat means those who are sadhakas, like most of us. We are chanting, we are struggling, right? How many of you are chanting and struggling? So there is a room full of Bhavaushadat. So it becomes medicine for those who are in the struggling phase. As I told before, that in a college, two categories of people are in bliss. One who is a topper, who has revised 10 times, before the exam day visits different students' rooms and gives them more tension by asking them, you have not read this, you have not studied this. I have already studied 4 times. And the second category, who is in complete ecstasy, is one who has never attended a class. He has never seen how professor looks also. And he is convinced, even Lord cannot pass me. So what is the point of even trying? But those who are miserable are the ones in between, who have attended some classes, know what the subject is. They have not studied, but they know who has taken good notes. They are ready with the Xerox. They are sitting together with other similar people in satsang, burning the midnight lamp, trying to cram things and trying to pass. And they are the ones who are discussing, I got 2 KTs, you got 3 KTs. Oh. Other fellow doesn't even bother to look at the result because he knows all KT only. So therefore, this is Bhavaushadat, that those who are struggling, they should also hear Krishna Katha, because it should... Hey, what's that? You're trying to psych me. So the third aspect is Shrotra Manobhiramat. Shrotra Manobhiramat means those who have nothing to do with Krishna, not started bhakti. Nanda Gopal Prabhu is trying to see if one more Gauranga has come there. Send somebody from sound system. So, these are the 3 categories. And the 3rd category, one may think, Shrotra Manobhiramat means, even for those who are materialistic people, who have nothing to do with either Krishna consciousness, who are not on the stage of pure devotional service, but they also find interest in politics, war, love, romance, family drama. These are things which attract everyone. So therefore, Krishna has performed pastimes in such a way that if you take Prabhupada's Krishna book and read it, not from the perspective of a devotee, not from the perspective of a sadhaka, but just that you feel, I am not having some good time pass. Let me read some good stories. From that perspective also, it is super excellent. Because you cannot find any actor having so many girlfriends in history. And you cannot find anyone who has managed to marry so many, may have married but still managed to keep them. Not just keep them, kept them happy and blissful. And so the entire range of pastimes covered is so attractive, enchanting. Therefore, these three categories are described here. So, we'll first discuss about how Krishna appeared. So, all the demigods, including Brahma, so first Bhumi Devi approaches Lord Brahmaji. So, we'll just discuss three things. One is some pastimes before Krishna appeared, and then when Krishna appeared, how was Vasudev and how was the Vasudevji reciprocating with him? And then after his appearance, when Krishna was with Yashoda Mai, then how Krishna performed pastimes. And then we'll see how wonderfully attractive these pastimes are. And in order to establish the beauty, super excellence, purity of these pastimes, Krishna actually appeared. So Bhagavatam describes Gaur Bhutva Ashrumukhi Khinna Krandanti Karunam Vibho. So as far as Mother Earth was concerned, she was oppressed by demoniac forces and she took the form of a cow. Gaur Bhutva Ashrumukhi Khinna, and she became filled with tears. And Krandanti Karunam Vibho, she went in front of Lord Brahma and started crying. She expressed the situation of her heart. And at that time, she reveals to Lord Brahma that I have been overrun by demoniac forces and I cannot tolerate this anymore. So Brahmaji is the leader of this universe. He is the firstborn from Lord Krishna. Brahmaji is known as Atma Bhu, Swayam Bhu. He is directly born from Garbhodakshay Vishnu. So when Brahmaji with so much of power and potency is approached by Mother Earth in a helpless state, what is Brahmaji's response? That is very interesting. All of us have one head and we have tough time keeping it free from aching. Brahmaji has four heads, and with his four heads, every decision he takes with regards to the creation, the management of the creation, is perfect. That means what a capacity he has for problem solving. That's the main point. What an amazing ability he has to grasp a problem, understand a problem, analyze the solution and apply it, knowing whom to delegate it to. He can do that because that's how he is managing this entire creation. But one of the aspects of intelligence is also to know the limits of my own capacity. That also requires tremendous intelligence. And therefore Brahmaji is what he is, because he understood this is beyond my capacity. And that is one of the biggest traps people get into. If I can solve 99 problems, I have the capacity to solve the 100th problem also, irrespective of whether I am qualified or not. That requires humility. So therefore, the combination of intelligence and humility is very rare. But if it is there, it is deadly. And here, Brahmaji, with his intelligence, realizes that I cannot solve this. I need help. So first of all, he takes all the demigods with him. Brahma tad upadharyatham sahadevais tayasah. Sahadevais, all 33 crore demigods, they come along with Brahmaji. जगामसत्रिनयनस्तीरं क्षीरपयोनिधे दे गो टू द तीरम टू द शोर ऑफ पयोनिधे ऑफ द मिल्क ओशन. ब्रह्मा जी ऑल्सो टेक्स विथ हिम हुम थ्री नयनस द थ्री आइड वन. जगामसत्रिनयनस इज द थ्री आइड लॉर्ड शिवा. So Brahmaji is going along with Shiva and all the demigods. So the question is asked here, why Lord Shiva is being taken by Brahmaji? Lord Shiva is being taken because Brahmaji contemplated. If I go to Lord Vishnu and request Lord Vishnu that you please descend, and he asks why, and I say to destroy all of these demons, and then if he says that, you know, it is not very convenient for me, the timing is not good, I am busy, so many answers may come. So therefore, at least let me keep Lord Shiva with me and show him that if you are not ready to come, at least sanction him, because he is already in charge of pralay or destruction. So if you delegate him and give him order, he will take care. So therefore he takes along with him Lord Shiva also. Then the question is asked, why he took all the demigods and Mother Earth also? Because he understood that Lord may ask, is it your problem, Brahmaji? Because many times when you go and complain, then the person thinks it is my problem. Now if I go and complain, they'll say, is it your problem? So Brahmaji doesn't want to go back and forth. So he's taking all the 33 crore demigods to confirm it is not just my problem. Everyone is confirming it, and it is not our problem also, it is Mother Earth's problem. And so all of us are doing this on her behalf. So therefore all of them are traveling along with him. And why do they go to the ocean of milk? Because Brahmaji is so powerful that he can perform austerity anywhere and still access the Lord's vibration anywhere. But still, because he understands that Lord is everywhere, still we need to go to a particular place to develop the consciousness, to develop the concentration, to develop a certain mood. And therefore we come to the temple to chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Lord is everywhere, but we cannot focus and concentrate and get inspired to remember the Lord everywhere. So we need to come to the temple and take shelter. And therefore, Dharma was already present in India, but nobody was taking it to it seriously. His Divine Grace A.C. Bhaktivedanta Swami Srila Prabhupada, he took this message and went worldwide. And because Srila Prabhupada distributed these books and established temples, people became connected to Krishna consciousness and understood the meaning of Sanatana Dharma. Srila Prabhupada, when he was giving a lecture in the initial days, one girl suddenly got up and asked, Swamiji, why did this process of Krishna consciousness come so late to the West? Prabhupada said, we were waiting for you to be born. Prabhupada attracted the youth of America at that time, and he established this process by traveling all over the world several times at the age of 70 plus. One time Bhakti Charu Maharaj was asking us, do you really understand what Srila Prabhupada has done for you? And we said, yes Maharaj, we kind of understand. But do you really understand? Probably, at least some glimpse we have. He said, no, you don't understand. And I was shocked. We are not so, you know, foolish. Why don't we understand? So he said, the reason you don't understand is because you have not yet reach the age of 70. First you reach the age of 70, then you open the Leelamrit and read the pastimes and then try to do something by going on a Jaladuta, by going on a cargo ship and three heart attacks. And after the three heart attacks, Prabhupada got down at Boston. He didn't go to the cardiologist. He continued preaching. One devotee asked Srila Prabhupada, I have a desire to always remain at your lotus feet, to always sit at your lotus feet. Prabhupada said, that is never possible because I am traveling all the time. So usually when a person is that old, he prefers to just sit at one place and do some bhajan. But Srila Prabhupada wanted to establish Krishna consciousness worldwide. One reporter approached him and she said that, I see that you are building so many temples. All this must be requiring a lot of money. So you have established this ISKCON based on money? Prabhupada said, no. We have established this on the basis of Krishna's mercy. So this went above her head. So she repeated again. But to do anything like this, you need money. So you are depending on money. Prabhupada again said, no. We depend on Krishna's mercy. So she also couldn't get it. So she said, but where does this money come from? And Prabhupada repeated, Krishna. Who gives you this money? Krishna. So she couldn't understand. She thought probably Prabhupada is old, he didn't hear. So she turned to another devotee, Rameshwar Maharaj. And she said, where does the money come from? And he had no choice. He said, Krishna. So she thought, let me change the topic. She said, okay, Swamiji, you please tell me, before you became a Swami and started traveling, what was your family? How many children you had? What job you were doing? Could you tell me those things? Prabhupada coolly said, why should I tell you? She got bewildered. She said, pardon me? Prabhupada said, why should I tell you? So she got totally bewildered. So because she had to be polite, she said, Swamiji, if you wish, you may tell me. Prabhupada said, why should I wish? She realized the game is up. So Rameshwar Maharaj interjected and said, Prabhupada, generally in America, they want to know about the author more. If they know about the author, they will feel inspired to read the books. And therefore, if she writes about you, then more people will buy your books. Prabhupada said, then I will tell. That was his only interest, that people should understand Bhagavatam. And Prabhupada went to Shantipur to take blessings. At the house of Advaita Acharya, the Pujari was there. And one of his godbrothers met him and asked, Swami Maharaj, you are going to America, to the West? Prabhupada said, I am not going to the West. Srimad Bhagavatam is going to the West. And because the Bhagavatam cannot travel alone, I am traveling with Srimad Bhagavatam as his servant. Srila Prabhupada had that mood and he just went with the three volumes of Srimad Bhagavatam because he had that faith. So therefore, here we can see that all the demigods and Brahmaji, they are so powerful that even if they perform some yajna many times, Lord appears. But still they are going to the abode of the Lord, because when you meet an important person, you must go there. You can't just call the chief minister and tell him to come to your home. You have to go and meet that person. So therefore, they are going there. And after going there, what are they doing is described here. Tatra gatva jagannatha deva deva vrishakapim purusham purusha suktena upatasthe samahita. Tatra gatva, going there. What do they do? Jagannatham. All of these 33 crore demigods accept Krishna as Jagannath, one who is the Lord. So in India, the favorite question is, what is the position of Ganesh ji, Shiv ji, Durga ji, and so many other demigods and Santoshi Ma with respect to Krishna. 33 crore demigods are not able to solve their own problem in life. They are not able to solve this problem. They are going to the lotus feet of Lord Krishna. Tatra gatva jagannatham. And what do? Deva deva vrisha kapim. And they are praying, chanting, singing together, calling out to the Lord. So Brahmaji realized solutions to problems in life do not always materialize out of the brain. And this is the greatest mystery of life for intelligent people. Because intelligent people get used to having solutions simply by the tip of their fingertips, by writing the answers. How do intellectuals and very highly qualified people become highly qualified? Through academic education. And academic education is nothing but use of fertile brain. And by the use of brain, when we are able to solve problems at different levels and stages of life and go through higher and higher degrees of education, the mind becomes filled with this colossal misconception that because I could solve so many problems in examinations in school, college and university, I can solve any problem in life. That is the greatest fallacy. And we should learn from the example of Brahmaji and demigods who understand with all of our brains cumulatively put together, we are now faced with a problem which we cannot solve it. We can manage, we can control, we can do a lot in this universe, but we cannot solve these problems. We need the Lord's intervention and help. And I have seen, because in ISKCON 18 years, although I have come from a background from IIT, but because of the nature of service, you keep interacting with all kinds of people in society. And I have interacted with people who are highly intellectual and those who are not even educated. Those who may be labor, who have dropped out of school in 5th standard, 6th standard, who have not gone through the study so much. They don't even know what exam means. There is no conception of competing in their whole system, that competing for academic achievement or this or that, the system itself is not there. And I have seen an interesting observation that those who are highly intelligent, very highly educated, they have more difficulty accepting defeat, accepting the fact that they cannot solve a certain problem, accepting miseries and sufferings in life. And those who are never done anything major in life, they are anyway used to that paradigm. So even if they get some kind of disaster or disappointment or suffering, they just take it in their stride. And therefore, somebody was telling me that, you know, some of the very highly educated people, they stay, you know, in Anushakti Nagar. And someone was telling me it has another name. It is called Atmahatya Nagar. And when I went for the program in 2002, they were showing me this is where Baba used to sit, this is where the atomic reactor is, and this is the building from where people jump. Because people can't deal with defeat or what they perceive as defeat. So therefore, there are certain situations in life which can never be solved by the use of intellect. And we only have to depend helplessly on Krishna. All the karmic skills will fail. Janma, Aishwarya, Shruta, Shri acquired from previous piety will all fail. That's why when we enter the temple hall, we fall flat on the ground, accepting this fact, at least notionally. Realization may take some time. But we accept the fact that we are helpless, we are dependent on you. And that's what all the demigods are doing. That for this, the solution is not having a combined meeting, but coming together, meeting and glorifying the Lord. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare.
हरे राम हरे राम 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 हरे।
ऑन द बेसिस ऑफ स्पिरिचुअल नॉलेज चैंटिंग द होली नेम्स डिपेंडिंग ऑन कृष्णा हेल्पलेसली, दैट हेल्पलेस डिपेंडेंस ऑन द लॉर्ड इज अ साइन ऑफ ग्रेटेस्ट इंटेलिजेंस। सो देयरफॉर दिस इज अ ब्रिलियंट एग्जाम्पल बींग शोन of how Brahmaji is organizing all the demigods to come together for Sankirtan at the shore of Shirodakshay Vishnu's abode. So what does Vrishakaping means? Vrishakaping means, Vrisha word means Varshati. Varshati Kaman Iti. So Deva Deva Jagannatha, Tatragatva Jagannatha, Deva Deva Vrishakapim. So Krishna is always known as Deva Devam. Deva means Lord. Devam means of the demigods. So Deva Devam means Lord of the demigods. He is never called Deva Asuram. Although Krishna is the origin of all. That means that Krishna is particularly inclined to anyone who takes his shelter when he is in difficulty. So that is the difference between Asura and a Deva. That an asura will continue to use his brain till the last and not accept defeat, although he is defeated, although he is on the ground, the opponent is standing on his chest, the referee has declared defeat, still he will shout, I will win. Old age, disease, death is going to come and destroy us completely. But the asura will continue fighting. Whereas the demigod takes shelter. So Deva Deva means Krishna becomes inclined to someone who takes his shelter. And Vrishakapim means Varshati Kaman. Krishna fulfill all desires. All desires. Therefore, it is described that for fulfillment of desires, one need not go to any other source. There is absolutely no need. एच्छाय गोसाई तार चरण बंदन जहां होते विघ्ननाश अभीष्टा पुरन। सिंपली बाय द मर्सी ऑफ द ग्रेट सोल्स ऑल द ऑब्स्टिकल्स इन डिवोशनल सर्विस कैन बी डिस्ट्रॉयड, डिजायर्स कैन बी फुलफिल्ड। देयरफॉर वी हैव टू अंडरस्टैंड दैट फुलफिलमेंट ऑफ डिजायर्स कम्स बाय द मर्सी ऑफ द लॉर्ड। मेनी इयर्स अगो in the newspaper there was report that there was, you know, the wife of a big dictator somewhere in the Philippines, she had acquired so much of wealth, and when they raided her house, the authorities found in her house 7,000 pairs of shoes. Just see the extent of desires people have. When unlimited desires to enjoy and accumulate come, there is no limit. 7,000 pairs of shoes for one person. And at that time, there was a Sunday feast lecture and Radhanath Maharaj commented, because it was in the news everywhere. You know, that was coming everywhere in all the headlines. 7,000 pairs of shoes, 7,000 pairs of shoes. Maharaj said, you need a Virat Roop to wear all those shoes. What will one person do? How much does a person actually really need in life? So therefore, Varshati Kaman Iti. People say, I can't come to temple, I can't chant Hare Krishna, I do not have time for bhajan and katha because I'm busy making money. Because if I don't make money, I will not eat. And if I don't eat, I don't have a house, how I will stay? Papi pet ka sawal hai. And therefore I cannot come. But actually speaking, if we keep Krishna as the focus, everything else gets connected accordingly. And then the other word used here is Akapim, Vrisha. So only Vrisha means this, Varshati Kaman, one who bestows benedictions. And Akapim means Akampayati Kleshan Iti. In front of whom all the kleshas, distresses tremble, that is Krishna. Just by seeing Krishna, the distresses start trembling. And we would love that, right? If our own distresses start trembling. So therefore, it is described here that Krishna has the power to put our distresses in distress. So therefore, he is known as Vrisha Kapim, one who can fulfill all desires and he can eradicate all our distresses. One Indian boy who was being cultivated by Srila Prabhupada in India, after Prabhupada returned back from America. So he had a father, and this father was very much attached to smoking, and he was trying his best to quit smoking. He could not. And then he met Srila Prabhupada, and Prabhupada knew about his habit. So Srila Prabhupada mercifully asked him, "Have you quit smoking?" And the gentleman said, "Swamiji, I am a gone case. I cannot quit smoking like that. I need special mercy of Krishna. When I get special mercy of Krishna, I may be able to quit." So Prabhupada said, "Do you know the meaning of special mercy of Krishna?" And then Prabhupada said that in the Bhagavatam 10th canto, Krishna says, "Harishye tad dhanam shanahi." When I show my special mercy, when Krishna shows special mercy, two things happen. One loses his wealth, starts losing his wealth. And number two, seeing that he has become poor, all the relatives desert him. That is what happens when you will get special mercy. Do you want it? This man said, "I will give up on my own. I have no problem." So one should never think that we come to Krishna consciousness for the purpose of fulfilling some material desires. We come here and request the Lord like a businessman. "Let's have a transaction. Let's sign a contract. I will chant, you will give. I will jump, you give more. I keep serving, you keep giving." No. Bhakti means we just come to offer our hearts unconditionally and selflessly. Therefore, the difference in Shuddha Bhakti and other forms of Bhakti is we aspire for pure devotional service. Sometimes Krishna may protect, so those stories become glorious, and sometimes Krishna may not protect. But in either case, we are not concerned with Krishna's ability to protect us physically. We are concerned with our willingness to submit our hearts at Krishna's lotus feet helplessly. So here, a beautiful point comes across. Is Brahmaji expresses the situation of Mother Earth to Lord. Then Lord gives a reply, then Brahmaji comes back. And then Brahmaji communicates to the demigods what the Lord's reply was. And how Brahmaji communicates is very interesting. Puraiva pumsa bhadrito jaladrajaro bhavadbhir amshair yadubhir upajanyatam sayavat urvya bharamishvareshvarah svakalakshatya kshapaye charan bhuvi. Brahmaji is telling, "My dear demigods, I conveyed to the Lord Mother Earth's concerns, all of your compassion and empathy. And in fact, Puraiva Pumsa Avadhrito, Lord Vishnu already knew about this condition. And Dhara Jvaro, he was aware of how Dhara or Mother Earth is in suffering condition. Bhavadbhiramshai Yadushu Upajanyatam." And now Brahmaji says that the Lord has a request. What? Sayavat Urvya Bharamishvareshvara. That Supreme Lord Krishna, who is Ishwar of all the Ishwars, because of the weight on Mother Earth, Bharam, Sayavat Urvya, as long as he is there on this planet Earth, for what purpose?
Swakala Shaktya Kshapayan, in order to destroy by his Kala Shakti the demoniac forces. The Lord will perform pastimes on this planet. For that period, he has a request for all of you. He has a service for all of you. Bhavadbhir. So Brahmaji uses the word Bhavadbhir. Bhavadbhir amshair yadushu upajanyatam. Bhavadbhir, aap sab, all of you. Amshair, through your expansions. Yadushu upajanyatam, in Yadukul and other kulas, take birth to assist the Lord in his pastimes. Not eternally, but for the time when he is on the planet doing his service. Assist him. So the Acharyas give a brilliant commentary. Because at first glance, it doesn't appear that there is any problem in this message. But there is one problem. Lord Vishnu, he told Brahmaji, all of you take birth and assist me in my pastimes. Brahmaji went and repeated the message as it is. All of you take birth and assist Lord Vishnu in the pastimes. One person was missed out. Aap sab seva mein lagiye. Seva hi param dharm hai. Kisne kaha? Bhagwan ne kaha. Kiske liye? Aapke liye. Bhavat bhir amshair yadushu upajanyatam. So it is said, this was the seed of the Brahma Vimohan Leela. Bhavat bhir, that everyone else got an opportunity to serve the Lord. Many of them appeared in Vrindavan Dham also and served the Lord and became part of the Lord's entourage and pastimes. But Brahmaji remained above the pastimes. He remained above the service. And he could not directly enter into the service. And because of that, there was some problem. And he could not actually recognize the Lord's glory. He himself did not serve. He engaged others in service. So therefore, it is described here that when the opportunity knocks on the door, many times we complain about the disturbance. So opportunity for service will come just like that, at such a fast pace, we may not even recognize that this is an opportunity. Because many times opportunity for service doesn't come with a wrapping and a sign on top, this is an opportunity. It will just come. And if we miss it, then we may regret later. And therefore, Brahmaji, at this point, lost that opportunity to serve. And he regretted it later. So therefore, Radhanath Maharaj makes a beautiful point. Bhakti begins when we move out of our comfort zone. Devotional service begins. When we are submissive, then submissiveness leads to endless hope. And speculation leads to hopeless end. So it is always safer to be submissive than to be speculative. And therefore, we find here that this is a very, very beautiful section. One disciple of Srila Prabhupada, he had a desire. You know, Prabhupada never told him. He developed a desire that I should, you know, take that one white suitcase Prabhupada used to carry always. So he thought, I will get that suitcase as Mahaprasad. So he brought one big suitcase, thinking that Prabhupada will easily exchange it. So he came and gave that big suitcase to Prabhupada. And Srila Prabhupada, this is a brand new suitcase for you. Please take. Prabhupada looked at the suitcase and said, very good. Prabhupada opened the big suitcase, took the small suitcase, put it inside and locked it. Then Prabhupada picked up both, one inside the other, and looked inside the mirror and said, how do I look? And then Prabhupada took one tour. Again he came in front of the mirror and said, how do I look? So one disciple from Australia, he was sharing this pastime in Mayapur, and he was saying that rather than trying to serve our masters and our superiors, many times we develop various other desires, what to get from them. And that desire is never going to be auspicious. As I was telling about Bhuvaneswar, again Harishwari Prabhu repeated that pastime. There was one devotee, you know, was very big bodied. And he went to Prabhupada and said, Srila Prabhupada, can you give me sannyas? So Prabhupada said, I said you must be fit for sannyas, not fat for sannyas. So then after some time, Prabhupada wanted His Holiness Gaur Govind Maharaj to actually sit and complete the Bhagavatam. So he asked him, why it is taking so much time? He said, I don't have any help to manage. So Prabhupada said, what about this person who came to me asking for sannyas? We'll make him the manager. That was Prabhupada's desires. His desire was to take sannyas. So he said, but he wants to go to America. He's already booked his tickets to New York tomorrow. Prabhupada said, we can change that. Call him. So somebody went and told him, Prabhupada is calling you. As soon as he heard that, he understood something is going to happen. Sixth sense is very strong. He came in front of Prabhupada, offered obeisances. Srila Prabhupada smiled at him. He became more fearful. And Srila Prabhupada said, I want you to stay here and manage. He said, Prabhupada, that's impossible. Because as far as this place is concerned, I'm not, my health is not keeping fit here. I'm feeling very sick. Prabhupada said, don't worry. Only if you stay for a prolonged period at a place, the body adjusts. So you must stay here. He said, but Srila Prabhupada, India in general is very confusing and bewildering. I don't know what to eat, what not to eat, this, that. It is very confusing. Prabhupada said, I will give you all the details. What to eat, what not to eat, what are the good vegetables, this, that. You just stay here. But Srila Prabhupada, they have created a special department for me in New York. I have to go and take it over. Prabhupada said, I will immediately tell one more brahmachari to take over in New York. You don't have to go. He said, Prabhupada, I can't get along with the local GBC. Prabhupada said, today only I am changing the GBC. He just couldn't think of anything. So finally he said, Prabhupada, from morning till night I am so busy, I am not able to complete my 16 rounds. At least if I go to New York, I can chant peacefully. Prabhupada said, if you are busy morning till night, there is no need to chant 16 rounds. That's only for him. So Harishwari Prabhu, when he was giving a seminar at Wada, he quoted six stories of Prabhupada, where Prabhupada allowed someone not to chant 16 rounds. I won't give references. So finally he said, okay, Prabhupada, what do you want me to do? Prabhupada said, I want you to just stay here and manage. So therefore, to be submissive is sometimes extremely difficult because the mind rebels, the ego rebels, and so many reasons come that actually this instruction is not for me, it is for them. Bhavadbhiram shair yadushu upajanyatam. All of you appear and participate in the pastimes. Bahut jaruri kaam hai. You have to do that. It is very urgent. So therefore, we have to understand that even if sometimes we manage and delegate, the mood in which we must do that should be in the mood of being a menial servant of the Lord. So therefore, the principles of service in Krishna Consciousness Society is not exactly same as corporate management, because it is based on being a humble servant first. Then later, Brahmaji prays to Krishna, tadastu me natha sabhuri bhaga bhavetra vanyatra tuvatirascham yenahamekopi bhavajananam bhutva nisheve tava pada pallavam. Later, after the Brahma Vimohan Leela, Brahmaji says, "My dear Lord, now I regret why I did not take birth along with all the others." Tadastume nath sabhuri bhaga bhavetravanyatra tuvatirascham. Now I request you that I got bewildered thinking I am Brahma. I am so powerful. My prayer is in future. May I be born as bhavetra here, tuva anyatra anywhere else, tuva tirascham, even in some family of animals. But wherever I may be born, let me be counted as yenaham ekopi bhavajananam, as your intimate devotee. Bhutva nisheve tava pada pallavam, where the fragrance and the aroma of the dust of your lotus feet is very easily available. The fragrance of Krishna's dust of lotus feet is so aromatic, saugandhya. It is so attractive. It melts the heart, it churns the heart, it destroys all the anarthas. Bhutva nisheve tava pada pallavam. That lotus feet of Krishna is as soft as the buds of lotus petals. Pada pallavam. So Brahmaji realizes his folly. So therefore, the greatest demigods, who in one sense are completely free from any particular desire, you know, Brahmaji, Shivaji, Shivji, they are all pure devotees. But Shivji and all, they are constantly engaged in chanting Krishna's holy names and his glories. Nivritta tarashair upagiyamana bhavaushadat shrotra manobhirama. So now Krishna is born, Vasudev picks up Krishna in his hand. As soon as Vasudev picks Krishna in the hand, it is described here, tatascha shauri bhagavat prachodita sutam samadaya cha sutika grihat. So Srimad Bhagavatam is non-different from Krishna. When Krishna appears in society of animals, he is called Varaha. When Krishna appears as half man, half lion, he is called Narasimha. When Krishna appears amongst aquatics, he is called Matsya. When Krishna appears as a fiery Kshatriya, he is called Parashurama. When he comes as a peaceful Kshatriya, ideal male, he is called Rama. When Krishna appears as a book, as a Grantha, he is called Bhagavatam, Srimat Bhagavatam. Srimat Bhagavatam. Bhagavatam means the property of Bhagavan. Srimat Bhagavatam means that wealth. Srimat is wealth, right? Srimanta, Srimat. Srimat means wealth, property. Of whom? Of Bhagavata. Means those who are sons of Bhagavan. Because father's property, who get? Son gets. Father's property, son gets. Okay, who is the son of Bhagavan? Bhagavata. Those who are worshipping Bhagavan are called Bhagavata. So that property which has been reserved by Bhagavan for his sons as their rightful inheritance and claim is this Srimat Bhagavatam. Only the son is the legal heir. So Jnani, Yogi, Karmi, Mishra Bhakta, so many others, they cannot approach anywhere near. Dharma Projita Kaitavatra Parama Nirmat Saranam Satam. One has to become selfless. Nirmat Saranam is translated by Chakravarti Pad as selfless. Sometimes it is said non-envious. Basically it means selfless. Therefore, devotional service is recommended. Because till you serve, till you experience the pain in your body, mind, ego, intelligence, every part of our gross and subtle body should start paining. When that pain comes, then you realize what is selflessness. Then when you become selfless, then Krishna accepts you as his legal heir. Then you can taste and receive what has been kept in your quota. The inheritance. Srimad Bhagavatam. Otherwise we'll be licking the bottle from the outside. Nirmat Saranam. Becoming selfless. So therefore Vasudev here represents that. Tatascha Shauri Bhagavat Prachodita. So now that we have, okay, we may not be Nivritta Tarashair, but at least we are now struggling to practice Krishna consciousness as sadhakas. We are poor sadhakas, trying and struggling. So therefore, at least Bhavaushadat, this Bhagavat appears as an aushadhi to purify what? Our anarthas, which create selfishness. When we hear on a regular basis, gradually we become purified of the tendency towards selfishness. So, tatascha shauri bhagavat prachodita. Shauri, Krishna tells Vasudev, please carry me to Gokul. Please take me immediately to Gokul. Sutam samadaya sasuti kagrihat. So, beautifully, Shukadeva Goswami is mentioning, bhagavat prachodita. Bhagavan told Vasudev. But what Vasudev did, he made a nice box and sutam samadaya, he puts Krishna in that box and carries. First he makes a nice silken, you know, garment, and then he picks up baby Krishna who's just born, who's effulgent with all his beautiful locks, and then puts him and then lifts him and takes him. So the first line says Bhagavat Prachodita, Bhagavan told him. But how is Vasudev responding? Sutam samadaya. My son is telling me. He is not thinking, oh, Bhagavan is telling. Bhagavan is sarvashaktishali. So he can do everything. In fact, my dear Lord, you should take me to Gokul. I don't know why you are telling me that I should take you. There is something wrong here. So the tattva says Bhagavat. But the rasa is Sutam. So, one may think, your God is all powerful, he can take care of everyone and everything. Why he needs so many people to worship him, to dress him, make dress for him? The devotees have made such nice decorations and such nice dresses for offering to the Lord. On this day, I am remembering Gaur Krishna Prabhu and Murli Mohan Prabhu and Gagan Prabhu, whom I am missing very much on this day, because they would every year offer such nice, wonderful dresses to the Lord. We are praying for them on this day of Janmashtami. So why? Why do you need to offer so much? The Lord can take care. Sutam, one considers him like a son. Someone who is dependent. Then we are able to serve. Then we are able to serve the Lord in that mood. So therefore, here is described here. Sutam samadaya sa sutika grihat. Then he decides to take him. So at this stage, Vasudeva has no idea how it is going to happen. Vasudeva has shackles in his leg. The gates are closed. The guards are guarding. Yamuna is flooded. He has to go to, you know, all the way across. He has to cross the river and reach Gokul. Nothing is working out. Is it not? So how you will do it? How it is possible? Your pocket is empty. You have no money. You have no job. No job is likely also. And you are surrounded by so many other friends who are equally unemployed like you. And then you are given service that you build a temple worth 25 crores with your money. So what you will say? Good dream. How is it possible? It appears as impossible as this. Vasudev here, without thinking, just lifts Krishna. And as soon as he lifts Krishna, things start happening. So that is the beautiful point here. Ta Krishna vahe Vasudeva agate. As soon as he picks up Krishna, the shackles open, the doors open, and the guards go to sleep. So as soon as we pick up Krishna in the mind, every day in the morning by chanting his holy names, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. Everything starts happening. Everything starts happening as soon as our mind starts entering into Krishna. Prabhupada was in Detroit. He was giving a talk and he was saying, our Krishna consciousness movement is spreading all over the world. And so many devotees are working hard. But actually this Krishna consciousness is spreading worldwide by the mercy of Krishna only. And Prabhupada was speaking with his eyes closed. And suddenly he opened his eyes. And he looked in front. He saw the whole range of devotees were sleeping. He looked on the left, they were also sleeping. He looked on the right, they were also sleeping. And Prabhupada just said that the Krishna consciousness movement is spreading by the mercy of Krishna alone. And Prabhupada again, into the mic, again closed his eyes and said, it is a fact. It is a fact. So we may just become instruments and we may think by our power, by our service, things are happening. But it is actually by the transcendental sound vibration of Krishna. And therefore Prabhupada wrote the books. He wanted devotees to read these books, distribute these books, study these books. Most important. Right? And Prabhupada said, don't think these books are only for distribution. You go and give somebody, please read this book. What is in this book? You read and find out. What about you? I tried, I couldn't figure out. One Brahmacharya was distributing with many years back. You know, one time Sudama Prabhu and myself were book distribution partners. We used to distribute at church gate. So one more Brahmachari was with us. So he was looking very morose because the sun was pouring on the head and prasad was delayed, didn't come. So many problems were happening. So he was giving out the Gita with a morose look. Gita padhiye. Gita padhiye. So the guy who was the customer asked him, aap Gita padhiye bol rahe hain, aap to bade dukhi lag rahe hain. Mera to kuch hua nahi, aapka ho jayega. So who will ever buy such a book in that mood? So our process is chant Hare Krishna and be happy, not be miserable. I am chanting but I am feeling miserable. Let me make others miserable also. They made me follow four principles. Come, come, chant, chant. You also chant. You also start chanting. You're all chanting? Good. Meet me after 2 years. So one of the biggest problems in Krishna consciousness movement is there is a surplus of information and a deficit of application. So therefore, we need to apply more what we are studying, hearing, knowing. Because intelligence is such that it can catch information very quick. Nowadays you need only Google, Google Pad. You know, he's the biggest acharya now. No other acharya can match that memory, right? Anything, Vaishnava, non-Vaishnava, as Dayaram Prabhu was saying, there are only two things in life. Forget, remember Krishna and forget Krishna. Both you get in ISKCON. Opportunity to do. So therefore, Vasudev, when he picked up Krishna, by the potency of Krishna in his contact, all his problems were resolved and the strength to serve came. The obstacles in his service were moved. So many times people think, I will serve on the basis of my own power and skills. That never happens. We have to helplessly take shelter of the transcendental sound vibration. Krishna lifts us up in the airplane of the sound vibration. Then we can move forward. Otherwise, there will be obstacle at every step. One will become frustrated. प्रसादे सर्व दुखानां हानिरस्योपजायते प्रसन्न चेतस हियाशु बुद्धिर पर्यवतिष्ठति. बाय द प्रॉपर प्रैक्टिस ऑफ चैंटिंग एंड हियरिंग व्हेन वन इज सैटिस्फाइड विद इन दैट स्टेट ऑफ सेल्फ सैटिस्फैक्शन इज द इंडेमनिटी अगेंस्ट मल्टीपल डिस्ट्रेसेस विच विल हैपन इन अवर लाइफ. एज इट इज सेड दैट मिजरी इज कंपल्सरी बट सफरिंग इज ऑप्शनल. Therefore, the greatest need of the hour is, as Vasudeva picked up Krishna, we need to pick up our bead bag. When? Evening? Night? Late night? Afternoon? Morning? Early morning? So that is called Brahma Muhurt. Not Brahma Muhurt. It is a time to awaken and chant the holy names attentively. Prabhupada said, Krishna consciousness is simple. The philosophy is simple. The application is difficult. The application is difficult. On this day of Janmashtami, we have to really pray to the Lord to give us the inspiration so that we cry out to Him so that He enters into our heart. Gives us the inspiration to actually chant His names every day. Only when He decides, when He gives His mercy, all these things are possible. He agreed to appear as Vasudeva's son. He ordered Vasudeva to pick Him up. As soon as He picked Him up, all the shackles were gone. Bhavaushadat shrotra manobhirama. Bhavaushadat. So we are looking for that medicine which will destroy our greed, our pride, our lust. By contact with Krishna, when Krishna enters into that mind, all our anarthas can be destroyed. Vavarsha parjanya upamshu garjita sheshon vagatvari nivarayan phanai. Now it is described that as Vasudeva started walking, the guards were sleeping. And as he was walking, Vavarsha Parjanya, the cloud started showering on top of Vasudevji. Vavarsha Parjanya, Upamshu Garjita, and cloud was making little rumbling sound. Why? Because one, the cloud wanted to do his own Abhishek. Like yesterday many people did Abhishek, today many are going to do. So cloud was thinking, Krishna was born, Janmashtami day, Abhishek has not yet happened. So it is my service. So I have to do some Abhishek. Vavarsha Parjanya. Upamshu Garjita. And the clouds were also making some rumbling sound. Like nice mridang and dholak and everything playing together. Why? Because the cloud was feeling very happy. Number one, the cloud was thinking, from today, from now onwards for rest of eternity, Krishna is born. And his body is going to be compared with me. Cloud is thinking, Ghana, Shyam. Megha, Shyam. So he's thinking, market mein apna bhav badh gaya. You know, I am getting this opportunity. It is so nice. So he's going to the near the ocean. You know, it is, he's conveying, Upanshu Garjita is conveying a message to the ocean. And what is telling the ocean? That, yeah, you will also be compared as Daya Sindhu, Karuna Sindhu. But for you, the Sindhu come later. The important thing being compared is Daya and Karuna. Apna kya ghan shyam. Pehle ghan, fir shyam. So, Vavarsha Parjanya Upamshu Garjita, or he is telling the ocean also that may all your droplets which come out and I receive, because I am completely dependent on you, my dear ocean. Whatever you donate, I accept. But don't think I am simply accepting and eating for myself. I am using it in Krishna's service. Therefore, just see where it is falling on Krishna. Okay, so you be rest assured. Sheshon Vagat, it is described, Vari Nivarayan Panai, and Shesha was behind. holding, you know, on top. So why suddenly it is described Sheshonvagat? Why Sheshanag was walking behind? All of you have seen picture how Sheshanag is. Sheshonvagat vari nivare anfane. Why Shesha was walking behind Vasudev, not in front of Vasudev? Also he could have turned around like this or from the side. Why is walking? Anyone who is carrying Krishna, one must serve them and we must follow in their footsteps, not go in front of them. So therefore he want to serve Vasudevji, thinking that he has become a servant of Krishna, let me become a servant of the servant. And Vari Nivarayan means Sheshanag is thinking that why I should allow this third class nectar, which is rain, to fall on first class nectar, which is Krishna's body. Where is Krishna's body, pure original nectar, and where is this rain? So Krishna doesn't deserve to be under the influence of third class stuff. So he covered Krishna like that. Maghoni varshat asakritya manuja gambhir toyoga javorni fenila. So now Yamuna Devi is described. So Maghoni Varshati, Indra was pouring down the rain. Asakrit Yamanuja, torrential rains were coming incessantly without stopping. So Shukadev Goswami is thinking about tender baby Krishna and how he has to be secured nicely. He has to reach the other end of Gokul Mahavan safely, and is thinking at this point Yamuna, being a devotee, should actually be assisting by becoming quiet and peaceful. But Yamuna is in spate. Yamuna is in storm. So the word he is using for Yamuna here is Maghoni Varshati Asakrit Yamanuja. So Shukadev Goswami is emotionally very angry with, you know, Yamuna. And therefore he is saying, what else can you expect from the younger sister of Yamraj? Family ka hi problem hai. Yamanuja. Right? So therefore she is showing that anger. Like in like Brajbihari Prabhu will describe about Kaliya. So in that one verse comes, Tam tatha kataram viksha Bhagavan Madhavo Bala. So when Krishna is in the coils of Kaliya, everyone is in helpless state, crying out, all the cowherd boys, cowherd girls. Only one person is peaceful and smiling and telling everyone, don't worry, no problem. That is Balramji. So Shukadeva Goswami, he doesn't appreciate that mood of Balram, that one should be also in that Vatsalya helplessness, and this Balramji is giving a cool smile. Tam tatha madhava. So he's saying, tat tatha kataran viksha Bhagavan madhava bala. So Shukadeva Goswami, out of anger, Sanatan Goswami says, Shukadeva Goswami was a little angry with Balramji. So he's calling him Bhagavan Madhava. Madhava means resident of Mathura. Resident of the city. Resident of city, little hard-hearted. No compassion. You know? And Madhava also means that in, you know, Madhava also refers to Madhu, one who has too much Madhu. Means too much of intoxication. So Madhava, he must be in intoxicated state. And intoxicated people don't know what they are doing. So instead of showing helplessness and crying, he is smiling. And also Bala word he used. Bala, he is Balaram. Balaram means one who is extra powerful. One who is extra powerful, unka thoda. Sometimes they have some issues. Bala. You know, so Shukadeva Goswami also uses the word very appropriately. Seeing Yamuna in spate, he says, Maghoni Varshat Asakrit Yamanuja Gambhiratoya Ogha Javorme Fenila. So Java means very forceful. Urmi means the waves. Fenila means foaming. And Gambhira means very deep. Toya. So the water of Yamuna was deep and swirling around in waves, and it was creating foaming. And therefore this appeared to be Bhayanaka Varta Shatakula Nadi. And this appeared to be very deadly. But as soon as Vasudev entered with Krishna's beautiful lotus feet in his hands, Yamuna Devi suddenly turned and all her waves moved up. So it is described that why Yamuna Devi was showing such a frightening state. So one reason is given that Yamuna Devi was not very happy with Sheshnag, seeing Sheshnag. Because Yamuna Devi is thinking, I already have one snake, Kaliya, inside me. One more snake is coming. Let me frighten him. So in order to frighten Sheshnag away, she is showing that state which makes Shukadev Goswami call Yamanuja. But also, then she opens her heart and it is said Yamuna Devi wanted to impress Krishna because she knew Krishna is going to be veer. So let me also show my power so that later he is impressed with me and wants to marry me. So let me show some power like that. So in this way, Yamuna Devi is trying to attract Krishna's attention. But being the servant of the Lord, she moves apart and allows Vasudevji to walk through. Therefore, a heart filled with anarthas, with avidya, with sanskaras, which are not conducive for Krishna consciousness, which are obstacles on the path of the bhakti, just like the gates and the shackles and the guards of Mathura's prison. But as soon as one comes in contact with Krishna and holds Krishna, then automatically all of these anarthas can be moved. The path to Gokul Mahavan is opened up. So therefore those who are sadhakas should strive very sincerely to remain in contact with Krishna by following the right process, and that is hearing and chanting of the holy names and the Bhagavad Katha. Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama. And now we'll end with this pastime of Krishna in Gokul. Said, Shrotra Manobhiramat Nivritta Tarasher Upagiya Manat Bhavavushadat Shrotra Manobhiramat. So even if someone is not a devotee, even if someone is not interested in Krishna, if he just hears any pastime, just like a story also, he becomes very attracted. So Krishna in Gokul Mahavan is playing with Yashoda Mai. So any materialistic person also likes to hear about small children. One of the common topics in families is what the small child is doing. What did he do this week? What did he do last week? What will he do in future? Not too much in future. That is not very nice to think. But, you know, this is something very common. So Krishna, one day, he eats dirt. So this comes in the 8th chapter of 10th canto. So as soon as Krishna eats dirt, all the cowherd boys go and complain to Mother Yashoda. So first they go to Balramji, and Balramji goes and complains to Mother Yashoda. So what Krishna was doing was he was eating dirt in seclusion. So the Acharya say the reason the cowherd boys complained was every day they would steal together and eat together. This time he decided to do alone. So he didn't take them as partners. So they didn't like it. And so Balramji goes and complains. So why Balramji complained? Balramji is thinking, Are you have come to decrease burden of Mother Earth by eating 2-3 grams of earth. You think you are going to decrease burden? Nonsense. What is this going on? Useless. So Balramji was not impressed with this. So when Yashoda Mai caught hold of Krishna and said, even Balramji is telling me, Agraja Api. Agraja is also telling me. So Krishna is protesting. You know, in Vrindavan there are so many stories. So Krishna is telling Mother Yashoda that actually Balramji is always teasing me. He is always telling all the cowherd boys that Yashoda Mai is fair and, you know, Nanda Maharaj is fair. This fellow is black. From where you came? From which market you were purchased? And then Krishna says to Mother Yashoda, this Balramji is always teasing me and he always makes all these comments about me. Make sure that when I am being married, you don't call him. Because he will create rumors and not break my marriage also. We will go at night and quietly get married. You know, and Krishna, Mother Yashoda said, don't worry. One of these nights, I'll get you married, don't worry. Right now you sleep. Then Krishna goes to sleep, suddenly gets up and tells Mother Yashoda, when is the marriage procession? Yashoda Mahi says, go to sleep, Baba. So, Krishna eats the dirt. So why he eats the dirt? So first is, Acharyas say Krishna want to taste the dust of his devotees' lotus feet. Because Vraja, Bhumi, Vrindavan is filled with all the Brajavasis' dust. Right? So therefore, when Akrura comes to Vrindavan, he falls on the dust of Vrindavan. Deham bhritam iyan artho hitva dambham bhiyam shucham sandeshatyo harirlinga darshana shravanadibhi. Akrura says, this is the purpose of this body. The soul has been carrying this heavy weight for so many lifetimes. For what? For this purpose. Deha bhritam iyan artho. This is the success of carrying millions of useless bodies for millions of births, so that we can ultimately roll on the dust of Vrajbhumi, Vrindavan. Hitva dambham bhiyam shucham, giving up pride, giving up shyness, giving up all attachments, giving up all feelings of honor. Sandeshatyo harirlinga, just by seeing Krishna manifest, by getting an opportunity to contact Krishna and associate with Krishna, that is the only purpose. That is the greatest success. So therefore, Krishna here, it is described, is very eager to taste that dust. Secondly, it is described that Krishna wanting to show his childhood pastimes as a human being. So small children, they don't have discrimination what to eat. Whatever you give, they put in the mouth. You know, they don't have much discrimination. Like in Jagannath Puri, we were for a yatra and one monkey entered into our room. And one Western devotee was sharing the room with me many years ago. And immediately, the monkey we saw was having an apple in his mouth. Not the fruit, iPod. Which he picked up from the room. And this devotee was like so shocked because it had just come out, you know, few months back, and he had paid a lot of Lakshmi. And we did all kinds of things to get him to leave it. He tried, he tasted, it didn't appear very attractive to him. So he finally threw it. So children are like that, that they don't have much discrimination, put everything inside. So Krishna is saying, Athanyat api Krishnasya toka charitam adbhutam. Parikshit Maharaj is saying, speak the pastimes of Krishna as a child. They are attractive. Even any normal person likes to hear about children and what they do and how sweet it appears. And then it is said, Krishna is eating dirt. Why? Because Krishna is feeling that I must do some prayaschit after speaking so many lies. Because Krishna has been speaking so many lies. Did you steal butter? No. Sure? Not at all. Whoever is speaking all nonsense. So Krishna is feeling, I have spoken lies. So the Vedic literatures describe that if you speak a lie from your mouth, immediately after that you should go and gargle the mouth and do achaman and spit water out. So if we do that, full day will be in bathroom only. Because so many lies we are speaking. That is a recommendation. That water should come in contact with the mouth after you speak a lie. So, but also there is another way of purifying. Another purifying agent is mud. Mud is also considered a purifying agent. When water is not there, sometimes people use mud. So Krishna is thinking, let me purify my heart. Let me purify by that speaking of lie, by eating this mud. Also it is said, Krishna thought that let me use this opportunity of eating mud to make a cover for my other stealing pastimes. Because all over Vrindavan it is very famous. Krishna is stealing butter. Krishna is stealing curd. Krishna is stealing this. Krishna is stealing that. All gopis, gopas, all are speaking about it. So Krishna thought, let me change my branding. This is a very good opportunity. So as soon as Krishna put the dirt in his mouth, everyone started complaining. So Yashoda Mai comes and catches Krishna. And now Krishna is telling Yashoda Mai, he's thinking what I will tell. I am eating the dirt and mud from my own courtyard. And these people can't digest. These people cannot accept the fact that I am eating some dirt from my own courtyard. So do you think these people will ever allow me to go and eat anything in their houses? Is it ever possible? Do they have such a large heart? Huh? Dekho. Kya halat hai inka? They are not allowing me to eat from my own courtyard. So all those previous stories you have heard, it is all bogus. Just understand this. So Krishna is trying to use this pastime as a means. Another reason given is, Krishna thinks that I have eaten too much butter and ghee. And Ayurveda says that to counteract too much butter and ghee, you should take something dry. So let me take some Ayurvedic treatment. So he took that butter. Also, Krishna thought, I have drunk Putana's poison. You know, we just saw today morning. Very, you know, graphic description about Putana. Brilliantly acted by Sridhama Prabhu and Shadbhuj Prabhu and Lokesh Prabhu. So, Krishna is thinking, I have drunk so much of poison, and it is described that vishasya visha aushadham. Vish is the aushadhi for vish. So therefore in Sanskrit, dirt is also called vish. So let me counteract that vish of Putana with this vish, which is the dirt. So another reason it is described is Krishna wanted to feed Vrajraj to all the jivas. Because all the entire creation and everything is within Krishna. Aham sarvasya prabhu. So Krishna thought, why all the Vrajavasis, why all the jivas should not get this opportunity? Let me show compassion to all. And so Krishna took that. Then Krishna thought, I have come for vinashaya cha duskritam. I have come to annihilate demons. I have to annihilate demons, fight with demons. I have to destroy so many armies of Jarasandha. I have to kill Kamsa. I have to construct Dwarka. You know, I have to manage so many families. I have to do a lot of activities which will be in Rajogun. So let me accumulate some Raja. Let me prepare myself with some Raja. So he was eating that Raja to prepare himself for that pastime. Like that. And in this way, so many reasons are given by the acharyas. So this is known as Shrotra Mano Bhiramat. Just hearing the pastime that a small child is eating dirt and mother is chastising, that is very pleasing to the ear. But when you understand the meanings and the different angles which acharyas give, it is very pleasing to the mind. Just by hearing the original pastime, it is very pleasing to the ear. And when you understand the deeper meanings inside, it becomes pleasing to the mind. Nivritta tarshair upagiyamana bhavaushadat shrotra mano abhiramat. In this way, Krishna katha is the only thing, Krishna lila is the only thing which is pleasing to all categories of people. To the muktas, to the sadhakas, and to those who are completely engrossed in sense gratification, to the materialistic people. Which is very rare to find somebody agreeing upon all this. Ka uttama shloka gunanuvadhat puman virajyet vina pashughnat. Who will not accept this? पशुघ्नात्, पशु, पशु रेफर्स टू द सोल, अपशोक, दैट विच इज बियॉन्ड शोक इज अपशोक. सो अपशु रेफर्स टू द सोल, आत्मा, वेर देर इज नो शोक, आत्मा डजंट हैव एनी शोक. सो अपशु घ्नात मीन्स वन हु किल्स द सोल, दैट मीन्स वन हु डजंट चैंट, वन हु डजंट हियर, वन हु डजंट प्रैक्टिस द प्रोसेस ऑफ कृष्णा कॉन्शियसनेस, ही इज एक्चुअली किलिंग हिज सोल. सेकेंडली प्रभुपाद सेज पशुघ्नात मीन्स दैट वन हु इज अ बुचर, वन हु किल्स एनिमल्स, ही सो मच इन तमोगुण ही कांट अप्रिशिएट कृष्ण कथा. थर्डली समबडी हु इज कॉन्स्टेंटली एब्जॉर्ब इन एंजॉइंग इन हेवनली प्लैनेट्स, he does so many animal sacrifices, he is a karmakandi, he want to go to heaven, swarga, his mind is filled with that desire. So krishna katha doesn't rest in his mind, he is also pashugnath. So in this way pashugnath has all these meanings. Puman virajyet, puman word is used, puman is different from stri. Puman means a male, which male will give up. So because it is described that women are always dependent, so women will be under control of husband or of the father or whatever, but and so sometimes husband or someone else may say don't go to katha, don't hear krishna katha, so they may not have too much choice, but men have choice, right? So puman, so if they have choice, then what force is there which can stop them from going to the katha? Because such a katha is so attractive. Nivritta tarshair upagiyamana bhavaushadat shrotra manobhiramat ka uttama shloka gunanuvadat puman virajyet vina pashugunat. In this way, on the occasion of Janmashtami, let us pray at the lotus feet of Shri Shri Radha Gopinaji that they bestow their unlimited causeless mercy upon us, so that being in the situation of trying to practice Krishna consciousness, all the obstacles on the path of devotional service may be removed. Let us also pray for all those disciples of Srila Prabhupada who have spent their several decades practicing and preaching Krishna consciousness, and many of them are growing old and going through so many health crises. And therefore it is our duty to also pray to the Lord to protect them and keep them in good health, so that they remain with us for many, many more long years, inspiring us in Krishna consciousness. And let us pray that the society of devotees created by Srila Prabhupada, and specially created here by the hard efforts of His Holiness Radhanath Swami Maharaj, we are able to actually serve the devotees in this association and not take these devotees cheaply and commit offenses at the lotus feet. Let us pray to the Lord to protect us from these kinds of offensive mentalities. And may we serve the Lord, you know, to the full capacity. In fact, you know, one of my school friends, in the sense we grew up together from childhood till the 7th or 8th class. And, you know, and we lost contact with each other. But then he came to one ISKCON temple and bought one picture of Yashoda and Krishna. You know that picture of painting of Krishna sitting in Yashoda Mai's lap? So he purchased that and they kept it their house. And they were so enchanted by that picture, they just loved that picture. They didn't know anything about ISKCON or Krishna consciousness movement. Then they moved from India, they went to Bahrain. And when they went there, you know, they came in contact with the devotees. Because they just said, let us try to find out more about this picture, about Yashoda and Krishna. Just that one picture inspired them. And they got the association of devotees. They started chanting. And now that, you know, friend of mine is chanting 16 rounds. And today he has come, you know, to meet me. After many years we'll be meeting. But that is the power of one picture where Yashoda Mai is holding Krishna. And that creates curiosity in the mind. What is this? What is this? What is this? And therefore Srila Prabhupada, he included so many pictures in his books also. And many people purchase books by seeing those pictures. And Prabhupada spread the entire Krishna consciousness movement on the basis of those books. Books are the basis. Books are the basis, but they are the most difficult to open. They are the most difficult to open. In fact, when the brainwashing case was going on against ISKCON, Prabhupada was told by the devotees, the lawyer is charging heavy fees. Prabhupada said, if they are saying ISKCON is brainwashing, we will defend. ISKCON is a cult, they were saying. Prabhupada said, we will just bring Bhagavatam and our books in the courtroom. And Prabhupada said, you argue from the Bhagavatam. First canto, first chapter, first shloka. Speak for 1 hour. Explain who is Krishna. Next day, speak the second verse. Third day, speak from the third verse. Convert the court case into Bhagavatam class. Prabhupada said that. And they did that. And after 1 week, the judge asked, how much more evidence you have? Because this was going too much. And they showed the whole set of books. And the judge got worried. Because probably he was also feeling sleepy. So he called up his friend who had a set of books. And that friend was professor of divinity in Harvard. And he said, what do you think about this ISKCON and Hare Krishna and Swami Prabhupada? He said, Swami Prabhupada, authentic. The books are authentic. It's not a cult. They are bona fide religion. And next day, that judge gave a declaration. ISKCON is not a cult, it is a bona fide religion. Just on the basis of the books. Srila Prabhupada ki. So Prabhupada said, the need of the hour is to study these books, understand these books, speak and distribute and write more and more Krishna Katha. Flood the world with Krishna. And that's why Krishna has descended on the occasion of Janmashtami. So let us give the world the opportunity to come in contact with Krishna by dedicating our lives in the mission of Srila Prabhupada. Thank you very much.